strategy here? Let's bring in CNN political commentator Anna Navarro and CNN political commentator Ben Ferguson. Great to see both of you, Ben.
Morning.
What's the strategy of going to war, a public war with Bob Corker?
Well, I think the president's pretty clear about this. He thinks that Bob Corker is someone that is coming after him in a way that he doesn't appreciate. He's going to fight back very clearly. Bob Corker has not helped this president in the Senate. When the president's tried to be open with him, have him over the White House and work with him, pretty much every chance that Bob Corker's had, it's been to undermine the president. That's the reason why he's having to retire. Look, in Tennessee, I do a radio show there every day. Bob Corker was not going to get reelected. There are a lot of citizens in Tennessee that are very upset, very angry with him, feel like he's been a fraud, a rhino, a Republican in name only, and that's why he had to retire. So I think, look, having this fight, I don't think it necessarily does any damage, because when the president's been nice to him and worked with him, Bob Corker is not led on the issues he promised his voters in Tennessee that he was going to lead on, and that's the reason why he's being forced to retire now, because he knows he was going to lose otherwise.
Like what? I mean, I'm just curious, before we get to Anna, what is he not conservative enough on?
Well, I mean, I think many people believe that, one, he messed up completely with the Iran deal, the nuclear deal, and that's where he lost a lot of support. Second of all, they don't feel like he's led on the issue of immigration reform very much. He has not led on Obamacare the way that he promised he was going to, and go out there, in his words, he said, I'm going to fight hard to repeal and replace Obamacare. He's been a guy that's played both sides of these issues by saying one thing to the voters that elected him in Tennessee, and then he's done another thing when he's in Washington.
Okay.
That's why, again, he's retiring for one reason. It's because he knew he was going to lose in this next election. He knew that the people in Tennessee realized that he's defrauded them. And so having a public fight with the president here, I don't know if there's any downside for Donald Trump for the fact that Corker, when they have played nice, has done nothing for him.
Anna, what do you think?
Look, I think it's refreshing to hear Republicans say publicly what so many of them have been saying privately. Any 12-year-old kid in middle school can tell you that if you let yourself be bullied once, you're going to be bullied twice and thrice and the rest of your life. So I think Bob Corker right now is unmuzzled. He's got nothing to lose. And look, Bob Corker is a guy who is not a career politician. Much like Donald Trump, he is a businessman. He was a very successful businessman. In fact, I think he never declared bankruptcy, certainly not four times. Very successful guy in Tennessee. He's older now. He can do whatever the hell he wants. He can say whatever the hell he wants. And I think that's what you are going to see. So you really, you know, as a Republican, you've got to kind of scratch your head, because you've got Donald Trump at war with John McCain, the chair of foreign, you know, the chair of Armed Services Committee. You've got him at war with Bob Corker, who's the chair of Foreign Affairs Committee. These are major committees. These are things where he needs to get things through and things passed if he's going to have any legislative accomplishments. So yes, he's, you know, scratching the itch right now, because we all know Donald Trump has no impulse control, and when his Twitter finger gets itchy, he shoots, you know, from the hip. That being said, at some point, he's going to need to get appointments through Bob Corker's committee. Every ambassador needs to go through that committee. If he decides to get rid of Tillerson, whomever replaces Tillerson needs to get through that committee. He's going to have to get legislation through that committee. He needs Bob Corker. It's an integral part of foreign policy for the United States.
And what about what she's suggesting, which is it might be satisfying to have this fight with Bob Corker, as you say, Ben, but how is it helpful?
Sure. Well, let me say this. I'm going to quote Bob Corker. He talked about and referred to the president as, you know, daycare center at the White House, and someone didn't do their job this morning referring to the president. I would say that exact same quote to Bob Corker, and he should read it every morning. It's his job to settle a personal score with the president and not do things that he promised the voters who voted him in that he was going to work on, because you have a childish vendetta against the president, and now you want to walk out there and beat your chest as you're going out a loser because you can't get reelected in Tennessee because you lied and defrauded the people that put you in. Bob Corker's job is not to have a war with the president or settle a score. His job, if he wants to be taken seriously, as Anna described him, as a serious man who's an honest politician, is to do his actual job. And as a senator, he should do his job. If he says the president's acting like a child, then you need to act like an adult and do your job and not make up or to change your vote or not let someone come through the state
department
because you don't like the president personally.
I hear you, Ben, but it sounds like what Bob Corker is doing is engaging in some radical honesty. I mean, he's being.
It's not honest.
From his perspective.
It's not honesty when you only say it because you're not running for re-election. That's being a coward. Being honest is someone who is actually willing to say it when he was running for re-election.
Go ahead, Anna.
We started seeing Bob Corker be critical of this president way before he decided on whether he was running or not running for re-election. You will remember that post-Charlottesville, Bob Corker was critical publicly of Donald Trump's reaction or lack thereof to the white supremacists marching in Charlottesville. And it was very powerful because it was coming from a Southern man representing Tennessee. I ran into Bob Corker just a few weeks ago. He had still not decided whether he was running or not. I urged him to run. He's decided not to run. But, you know, this is a guy who represents the United States, right? And yet we are trying to put a higher standard on him, a higher scrutiny on him as far as not engaging in childish fights and name calling than we are on the president of the United States. Leadership comes from the top. And if we have a 71-year-old man baby as president, the senators have every right to call him out as so.
All right, Anna, Ben. Thank you very much for the debate.
Thanks.
That's one of Anna's favorite expressions.
Man baby.
Man baby.
She's got so many. Movie mogul Harvey Weinstein fired from the studio bearing his name after new revelations come to light. Allegations.